This tutorial shows you how to install Cygwin on your Windows computer so that you have the Unix-like terminal window that you need to use NCBI's EDirect programs. I'll also demonstrate the very simple EDirect installation. Let's get directly to the Cygwin installation on a Windows 7 system. At cygwin.com, you will find the Install Cygwin page, which is where I am now. Simply click on this Setup link, unless you happen to have an older 32-bit machine. What happens after clicking on Setup varies depending on the browser you are using, so follow your screen prompts to run that program or executable. Some of the decisions you will have to make during installation include Download Source, choose Install from Internet, Root Install Directory, Desktop/Cygwin is a good choice, and you might want to install for just me if you do not have administrative privileges. Local Package Directory. Downloads is often the default, and that is fine. Select your internet connection. Direct connection is a good choice. And choose a download site. The first one in the list is fine. After a brief download, which hasn't installed anything yet, this Select Packages menu appears. The EDirect programs are a set of Perl scripts, so you need to add the Cygwin Perl package, even if your Windows machine already has Perl installed. First, be sure that Category is selected in the View menu, then type Perl in the search box, and click on the circular arrows next to Perl in the list. The word Default will change to Install. EDirect installation also requires the Zip program, so search for Unzip or Zip, expand Archive, and click next to Skip. This will change to the version number of the Zip utility that will be installed. And you may want to install a text editor. If you are new to command line programs, Nano is an easy one to get started with. I won't demonstrate that, but note that you can come back anytime and rerun the setup executable program to add any additional programs or update the ones you have installed. No need to uninstall anything. Okay, after clicking Next, you will see this list of changes, so click Next again to begin the download and installation of Cygwin and the other packages. This often takes several minutes, after which you may see some post-install script errors, but in my experience those can be ignored. Click Next one last time, and you can now finish. If you already know how to install EDirect, you can skip the rest of this video. If not, let's use our new Cygwin terminal to do that. First, open the terminal window. In my case, I'll double-click on my desktop icon. Now I'll go to the EDirect documentation page at NCBI. Just search for NCBI EDirect in your browser, and you'll get to this page in our books database. This is a big and immensely helpful document if you want to take full advantage of EDirect's capabilities. For now, I'll just scroll down to the installation section and copy this text. Back to my Cygwin terminal, paste that in, and hit Enter, and away it goes. You should quickly get to this setup.sh shell script. Hit Enter again to run that script, and it will stop on this message about trying to establish local installations of any missing Perl modules. It may sit there for a minute or so, and in the rare case that the message is still there after 3 or 4 minutes, it is probably not going to finish on its own, so go ahead and stop the script with the keystroke Control-C, and move on. Let's check to see if the EDirect programs are working. One way to do that is to type a program name and ask for the version number. I'll do that by typing esearch space dash version. And I get a command not found error. This happens now and then if the installation did not add the location of the EDirect folder to your path. It's very convenient to have that so that you can run the EDirect programs from whatever directory you happen to be in. To correct that, I'll use the Nano editor that we installed to open up the file called .bash_profile. Scrolling to the bottom of that file, I see a path defined for Cygwin, but not for EDirect. You'll have to take my word for that since the full line is not displayed here. One way to add a new path is to add another line, so I'll paste in export path equals $path and then path to the directory. EDirect will normally install in your home directory. Alright, let's test this again. But you'll first want to log out of the terminal simply by typing logout or exit. That allows the changes made in the bash profile to take effect when you start the terminal again. So I've now logged out and have opened the terminal window again, and now I'll request that version again for eSearch. And we see not only that I've got version 8.6.0, but this also means that the EDirect programs are properly installed. You very likely have a newer version because EDirect gets updated fairly often. Another way to check the installation is to type the program name and dash help. I'll pipe that to another Unix command called more, just so the documentation doesn't scroll all the way to the bottom. This is a quick way to see the command line options without having to go to the documentation on the web. Okay, all seems well, but what the heck, let's run a real efetch command just to see how easy it is to use. This command retrieves a protein record in FASTA format and sends that to a file called np.faa or whatever name you give it. All I need is the accession number from the NCBI protein database. And there's the FASTA record. That's it. You're now ready to run EDirect on your Windows machine. In the YouTube description of this video, you'll find some useful links. And if you have any questions, feel free to write to us at info@ncbi.nlm.nih.gov.